Thank you, Sushma, and thank you everyone present here. Good evening to everyone. It's really a pleasure to see all of you today here for the inaugural session of Singapore Magento User Group. I know what it takes to take out time from your busy schedules on a weekday and make your presence here. Really appreciate your time and effort. Thank you again. To briefly introduce myself, I am Sangeeta. I work as Business Development Manager at Ranosys Technologies. We implement Magento solutions for our clients, and in my capacity as a Business Development Manager, I regularly interact with users of Magento or potential users of Magento. When I say potential users, I mean merchants who might have retail outlets and who want to build an online presence, or merchants who have an online store in maybe some other platform other than Magento. And in this capacity, in this role, I have gained deep exposure into Magento, and I'm here to share a little bit of knowledge with all of you. So today I'm going to speak about Magento 2.0. As we all know, Magento has recently released the new version of Magento. So the agenda for today's presentation would be a brief introduction about Magento, what is it all about, why Magento 2, key features of Magento 2.0, how does it improve upon the previous versions of Magento, and migration to Magento 2, what does it take, is it worth it? We'll look at all aspects in this part of it. So Magento 2, I believe all of us in some capacity have had some exposure to Magento, either as a developer or as a merchant or end user. In some way or the other, I think we all are Magento enthusiasts, and that's what brings us together here today. So Magento needs no introduction. It's the most popular e-commerce platform today. The largest market share, 30% almost market share, and the number of transactions really needs no introduction. And we have been using it for the past 7-8 years. And Magento 2 came as a beautiful gift to the e-commerce world. Now, this was a version which was very highly anticipated among the developer community as well as the user group, as well as user community, because people anticipated a lot of changes, a lot of variations, a lot of improvements and enhancements. And the initial response has been very positive. People have, the enthusiasm, that the hype and hoopla that went behind the launch, I think it's been justified. So, and all this expectation, all this anticipation, because it's a complete rebuild, I would say, over the previous version of Magento. If you see Magento 1.x, there are a lot of features which are completely revamped, like the backend. I'll talk about those in later slides. And that is why all this anticipation and this enthusiasm about Magento 2. I think late in 2014 itself, when they first launched the beta version for the developers, and it took them a complete year to make the merchant version available for general use. All along, people have been anticipating, what's going to be there, what's going to be new, and so let's see what's new in Magento 2. So people who have been using Magento might be familiar with this, little bit of concern that users have regarding the performance of Magento, version 1, 1.x. It's generally known to be very resource intensive. So in this aspect, Magento 2 has, delivered excellent results in terms of performance improvement. If you just see these numbers, they speak for themselves. If a user is simply browsing your Magento portal, the response time is improved by 25%. For other functions like a checkout or placing an order and adding a product to cart and making a purchase, the response time is even faster, almost more than by 50%. And how have they achieved this? By full page caching. So generally Magento websites are very database driven. They have to make a lot of calls to the database. In Magento 2, by caching, they are delivering it through, pre-rendering it through HTML pages. So the results are enormous. As a merchant, as an end user, what it means is a much better user experience when I'm shopping. A much quicker checkout process. Even if I'm browsing, there are no glitches. So as an end user, obviously it's a delight to use Magento 2. So obviously it'll translate to better conversion rate. If I'm a merchant, this will make me very happy, because a better conversion rate obviously translates to a significant dollar value in terms of revenues. But the other reason why, as a merchant, I would be delighted is, the investment that I need to make in my hosting infrastructure, that goes down a lot as well. in terms of like, if you have a better user experience and a faster process, then obviously in terms of SEO also there's a great benefit, because Google you know, rewards you if you're much faster based on your response rate, based if you're mobile optimized. So all these aspects also help you in improving your SEO performance. So all in all, as a user, you know, it sounds great if I have a faster website. As a merchant too, from a merchant's perspective, I have not only just top-line growth, but also bottom-line growth. It helps me improve my revenues by higher conversion rate. It also helps me optimize my cost by, you know, reducing my investment in server infrastructure. Moving on, as Sushma said, Magento is something that, you know, organizations of every size, there are startups, there are even huge companies that run Magento, and that is where the beauty of Magento lies, its scalability. Meaning, if you're a small e-commerce portal, you can start with Magento, but if you grow to a huge size, you have thousands of customers and orders, you need not change your platform. Magento is very, very scalable to support your thousands of users and orders. Magento 2.0 further enhances the scalability. If you see the number of page views per hour, there's a 1900% improvement as compared to Magento version 1.x. And just my sheer numbers, 10 million page views per hour, it's no mean achievement. And how have they achieved this? It's through database improvements. So earlier in Magento, version 1.x, they had a single database that used to handle all user queries. In Magento 2.0, they have separated the database. So there's actually one database that can handle page contents, content pages, such as your product pages or category pages. Now, once the user enters the checkout page or the placing the order, there's a different database that handles those queries. So that actually has helped a lot in terms of response rate to the end customer. Now, from an end user perspective, it was observed that it was the checkout page where the maximum number of sales drops used to happen, a lot of abandoned carts, because the inbuilt Magento checkout process was not very user friendly, and a lot of customization went into this checkout process, and some of them were not very error free. So to resolve these issues, what Magento 2.0 offers is a very simplified, streamlined checkout process. They have removed some unnecessary steps from the process. For example, Just a small example, the zip code goes before the state and the city fields. So the moment you enter the zip code, the city and state gets auto-populated. It might, these are small improvements, even if it reduces like half a second of your transaction time, accumulated change is a lot. It's a substantial change, overall if you sum up the total time. Another example is the credit card type. So now the system can automatically detect what's your credit card type. It's a Visa, MasterCard, based on your card number. So suppose it's a card starting with 4 is automatically a Visa. It's card starting with 5, it's a MasterCard. So these are small steps which they have reduced in the checkout process to overall optimize the checkout process for the end user. Now, continuing with the checkout process itself, it also allows guest checkouts and converts guest user to accounts. So I think a lot of us might have faced this while shopping online. They most often do not allow you to do a guest checkout. They will force you to either create an account or log in if you're already registered. Now, in Magento 2, what they do is it's optional to register or log in before you check out. And once you place the order, once your order is placed, it is after that when they prompt you to create an account if you want to track your order. So that is where, in terms of user experience, if I want to make a purchase, that process is smooth. It doesn't allow me to first, create your account. You have to remember your password. Next time you come in, you might forget your password. So it resolves all of that. It simplifies the process, allows you to, check out, place your order. And once you're done with that process, then you can create an account if you want to track your order. So in terms of value addition to the customer or to the end user, this is a much better process. Now, we talked a lot about the front-end user experience and all. Now, coming to the back-end for the merchant who is actually managing the store online, Magento 2.0 has a lot of features which, as a merchant, I would be delighted to look at. First and foremost is the flexible product page design. Now, they have a visual design editor which will allow the admin to customize the page designs by a simple drag and drop functionality. So I can just move around modules. Okay, I want this module here at the left bottom instead of the right corner. I can simply drag and drop modules around to create customized page designs. Now, next point is the bulk upload of images. Now, Magento 1.x obviously allowed you to upload products in bulk. Magento 2 also allows you to upload images in bulk. You can either apply the same image to all SKUs or bulk upload images for all the SKUs. Same applies to pricing as well. You can apply single pricing to all SKUs or, bulk upload of pricing as well. Enhanced dashboard and navigation menu. If you look at Magento 2, the admin panel, the navigation menu is completely changed, and even the backend is mobile optimized now. So it allows the admin to manage your store even from your smartphone, tablet, anything. It makes it much, much easier for an admin to manage their store online. It's a much more intuitive navigation flow. Integrated marketing tools. Now, Magento 2 also has many advanced customer segmentation and marketing tools available for the merchants. And you can have promotions based on a category. Suppose I'm a merchant who sells apparels online. I can run a promotion saying a 10% discount on all women's shoes, for example. Or for a specific cart value, I can have a promotion. So these kind of customized promotion tools I can run using Magento 2. Concurrent product and order management. As I said, now they have like separate databases which handle from the checkout process onwards. It's a different database that handles that. So this, what it means for me as a merchant is, I can have 20, 25 people who are managing the products from the backend. I can have 50 other people who are processing the orders. So you can work concurrently without affecting performance at all. Now, from a developer perspective, yes, easier installation and upgradation of co-Magento and extensions. From Magento 2 onwards, there's a significant change in this as well. Another very interesting feature that Magento 2 has introduced is the Magento testing framework, which allows you to have automated testing for functional testing, unit testing, integration testing, different types of testing that it supports. So you do not have to, you can yourself build automated tests for all of these scenarios. What it translates to, lower lead time and faster time to market. Now, having gone through some of the features that are key enhancements over Magento 1.x, I'm sure a lot of us have questions regarding, should I migrate to Magento 2? I'm sure a lot of you might be thinking right now, what are the pros and cons, and what does it entail if I have to take this step, if I have to migrate to Magento 2, what does it mean for me as a merchant or as a developer? So it's ideally advisable for merchants who are currently facing some performance or security issues. It's advisable for them to consider migration to Magento. Or if you're using a really old version of Magento, it might make sense to migrate to Magento 2. And to make this process of migration easier, Magento will make a tool available, a data migration tool, which will help you migrate your customer data, product data, as well as orders from Magento 1.x, whatever version you're using, to Magento version 2. So that's all I have from my end. Thank you for your patience. If you have any questions, you can shoot.
I'm sorry, I have two questions.
Sure.
So first question is, Magento runs on PHP, and PHP 7 was just released. Generally speaking, for most PHP applications, you increase 2 times in performance. Now, Magento is quite resource intensive on database on the database side. So I was wondering if I were to run Magento 2 on, let's say, PHP 5.5, and or 5.6, and then Magento 2 on PHP 7, will I see some significant increase in performance, or will it be trivial? So yeah.
I think Lalit would be in a better position to handle.
So definitely, if you choose the PHP version, also affect the performance. As in the PHP 7, the performance is increased, but it's raising by open source technology, like for WordPress, around 200% it increased. For Drupal, it's around 150%, I suppose. I don't remember exact, because there is a case scenario. We attended a presentation by Rasmus Ledorf here in the last year for PHP Asia conference. So it depends, actually. PHP 7 increased a lot, up to 200% than the PHP 5.5, but for Magento 2 also, it's
some benchmarking data is benchmarking. Already available on the web.
Already
there
available.
There are people who have tested with the PHP 7 and all those things. It's already there, something.
But it's a lot, actually. Significant improvement.
Then, because I was just trying out the, I think it was still beta last year, right? So I was just trying, so I'm not quite sure. Second question was, the beta, I think the REST API was, I think, not complete yet. Am I correct to say that? So I'm not quite sure now that it's released really. Is that
Magento 2?
Yeah. So is that portion?
No, it's stable release now.
It's stable release now.
Everything is now.
Okay. 2015, they actually released stable version.
Okay.
17
number. Beta was last year, so it's almost 1 year to launch.
I have a question.
Yeah, sure.
For a site that is currently running on Magento 1 EE Enterprise and decides to upgrade to Magento 2 Enterprise, would I need to renew the license? Or the current Magento 1 EE license would be enough for you to upgrade to the...
About the license, I'm not much sure. Kelvin can answer.
For the licensing wise, because Magento licenses are renewed every year.
Yes.
So I think it was 18,000 a year or so for Magento 1, right? 18,000 US, before discounts. Yeah. So once your licensing renewal is up, then you will have to renew. You can still use it, but once the renewal date is up.
Okay. Yeah. It's still due for a few months.
Yeah.
And if
the client decides to upgrade to 2, you can still get, anyway now, if you have paid for the 1 license, you can access to the 2 downloads as well.
Yeah.
So you can install it. So once it hits the date, we say 3 months later it hits that date, then you need to renew for 2, but 2 is a different pricing, they have revenue based pricing.
Mm-hmm.
So it's 22k US and above. It can go up to like 300,000 US a year, depending on revenue as well.
What is the base
revenue? Base revenue below 1 million US, so it's 22,000. Below 1 million revenue is 22,000, but it's self-declared, so you can declare whatever you want.
Okay. There are no more pricing information on the website.
No, it's all account manager pricing.
What is the migration tool? You mentioned the migration tool.
If there are no further questions, I would like to invite Khushbu for her presentation.